Hi students, yesterday we studied the relationship between the trigonometric ratios in terms of complementary angles, and today we have to continue the same concept. Here we have to get the different identities. So here we have a right angle triangle ABC. We have to write some trigonometric ratios there to the angle A, that is for acute angle A or for the acute angle C. We can use one of the two angles, either A or C. We will use angle A here. First, we have to write all the trigonometric values of angle of acute angle A. So here we will write first sine A. We have to write the ratio sine A. We have to write the ratio sine for this acute angle A. So here the definition of sine is opposite side upon hypotenuse. Opposite side of angle A, that is BC, upon hypotenuse is AC. So here sine A is equal to BC upon AC. Then we have to write cos A. We have to write all the ratios, all the trigonometric ratios for this acute angle A. So here we have to write after sine, we have to write cos. Cos A is equal to, the definition of the cos ratio is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. Adjacent side is AB upon hypotenuse is AC. Then we have to write tan A. The definition of tan A is the ratio tan. Definition of the ratio tan is opposite side upon adjacent side. So here we have to write opposite side of angle A, that is BC, upon adjacent side is AB. Opposite side upon adjacent side, that is BC upon AB. Then we have to write cot A, cot ratio for angle A. The definition of the cot is the multiplicative inverse or the reciprocal of tan. That is, we have the definition of tan ratio as opposite side upon adjacent side. So here we have to write adjacent side upon opposite side. Adjacent side is AB and opposite side is AC. So value of cot A, that is AB upon AC. Sorry, the adjacent side is AB and opposite side is BC. So the value is AB upon BC. Then we have to write sec A. We have to write sec A, and we know the definition of sec is the reciprocal of cos. The definition of cos is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. So here we have to write hypotenuse upon opposite, hypotenuse upon adjacent side. Hypotenuse is AC upon adjacent side is AB. So this is AC upon AB, and last ratio, that is cosec A. Definition of cosec ratio is hypotenuse upon opposite side, that is the reciprocal of sine. So here hypotenuse is AC and opposite side of angle A is BC. So here we write all the six values, all the six trigonometric ratios of angle A. And now here we have to get some identities. We will get some identities using these six values. We have to observe all these six ratios carefully. See, if we represent this as equation 1, equation 2, equation 3, equation 4, equation 5 and equation 6, and if we multiply equation 1 and equation 6, see, equation 1 and equation 6, if we take the multiplication of these two ratios, then we will get the identity. See, here we will represent these as equation 1, equation 2, equation 3, equation 4, equation 5 and equation 6. Now observe equation 1 and equation 6 carefully. If we take the product of 1 and 6, if we take the product of equation 1 and equation 6, then the multiplication of right side is 1 and the multiplication of the left side is sin A into cosec A. So here we can write साइन ए इंटू को सेक ए इट इज इक्वल टू वन, साइन ए इंटू को सेक ए इट इज इक्वल टू वन. एंड वी हैव द प्रूफ इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस, वी हैव द प्रूफ इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस. वी हैव इक्वेशन वन, वी हैव इक्वेशन सिक्स. And if we multiply these two equations, multiplication of the left side to the left side, that is sin a into cos a k, it is equal to, see the right side, bc upon ac multiplied by ac upon bc. Here we will write bc upon ac, that is the multiplication of right side, into ac upon bc. And this multiplication is equal to 1, ac ac gets cancelled, bc bc gets cancel, and the multiplication is 1. So we have sin a into cos a k, that is equal to 1. Similarly, if we take the product of equation 2 and equation 5, similarly, first we take the multiplication of 1 and 6. Now we have to take the multiplication of 2 and 5. If we take the multiplication of equation 2 and equation 5, see the left sides, cos a into sec a is cos a into sec a, that is equals to 1. Cos a into sec a, that is equals to 1. And now if we take the product of equation 3 and equation 4, if we take the product of equation 3 and equation 4, see the left side of equation 3 and 4, tan a into cot a is tan a into cot a, it is equal to 1. Tan a into cot a, that is the multiplication of left side to the left side. And we have to take the product of right side to the right side. Here bc bc gets cancelled, ab ab gets cancelled after multiplication, and we have tan a into cot a is equal to 1. We get the three identities here, that is sin a into cos a k, that is equal to 1, cos a into sec a, that is equal to 1, and tan a into cot a, that is equal to 1. Now here already we knows that sin and cosec are multiplicative inverse of each other, or they are the reciprocals of each other. And when two numbers are said to be multiplicative inverse of each other, if their product is 1, if the product of the two numbers is 1, then we are able to say that both the numbers are multiplicative inverse of each other, or we can say it as they are reciprocal of each other. So sin and cosec, they are multiplicative inverse of each other, cos and sec, tan and cot. See this structure is very important. First and last, second and second last, third and third last. Using this structure, we can easily remember these three identities, that is sin a into cos a k equal to 1, cos a into sec a, that is equal to 1, and tan a into cot a, that is equal to 1. And we can get 6 more identities from these three identities. We will get 6 more identities from these three identities. See, the first identity we get, that is sin a into cos a k, it is equal to 1. If we transfer this cos a k to the right side, we will get, see, sin a is remaining here only, sin a is equal to, see, this cos a k is into the multiplication to the left side. If we transfer it to the right side, it will went into the division. So 1 upon cos a, sin a is equal to 1 upon cos a. That is one more identity we have, sin a is equal to 1 upon cos a k. Now suppose we will put cos a k as it is, and we will transfer sin a to the right side. Sin a we have to put to the right side, cos a k we have to put as it is. So one more identity we will get there, cos a k is equal to 1 upon sin a. Just we have to remember this identity. We have to remember this identity only, or you can remember this structure. First is compared with last, second is compared with second last, and third is compared with third last. So here we have to, by using comparison, we have to remember these identities, or simply we use this into definitions also, definitions of the trigonometric ratio. Whatever the definition of sine, the multiplicative inverse of that is cosec. Whatever the definition of the cos, that is the multiplicative inverse or reciprocal of sec. And the definition of tan is the reciprocal of cot. Already we knows that while studying the definitions, at that time we knows this concept that sin and cosec are multiplicative inverse of each other, cos and sec are multiplicative inverse of each other, tan and cot, they are multiplicative inverse of each other. So we can easily remember these three identities, and we will get six more identities from each identity. See, this first identity, sin a into cosec a is equal to 1. If we transfer this cosec a to the right side, we get sin a is equal to 1 upon cosec a. And suppose if we transfer sin a to the right side and put it cosec a as it is, so we will get cosec a is equal to 1 upon sin a. Similarly, we will get two identities from this. If we transfer sec a to the right side, we will get cos a is equal to 1 upon sec a. Cos a is equal to 1 upon sec a. And suppose we put sec a as it is and transfer cos a to the right side, we will get sec a is equal to 1 upon cos a. Here we get two more identities. And no need to by heart these identities. If you knows this identity, you can prepare these two identities easily. If we transfer sin a and put cosec a as it is, we get cosec a is equal to 1 upon sin a. If we put sin a as it is and transfer cosec a to the right side, we will get sin a is equal to 1 upon cosec a. Similarly, here if we put cos a as it is and transfer sec a to the right side, we get cos a is equal to 1 upon sec a. And if we put sec a as it is and transfer cos a to the right side, we will get sec a is equal to 1 upon cos a. So we have to get two more identities here, that is tan a is equal to, now you can easily tell tan a is equal to 1 upon cot a. Or if we put cot a as it is, that is equal to 1 upon tan a. That is equal to 1 upon tan a. See, we have this 3 and these three and these three. Total 9 identities all. But we have to remember these three only, and these three are also too easy. This first is compared with last. Second is compared with second last, and third is compared with third last. These two, then these two, and then these two. Product is always 1. The reciprocal of sin is cosec. Reciprocal of cos is sec. And reciprocal of tan is cot. So here we write these three identities, and from these three identities we get these six identities, and no need to by heart these identities. या आयडेंटिटीज तुम्हाला पाठ करण्याची आवश्यकता नाही आहे. या आयडेंटिटीज जर तुम्हाला माहिती असतील तर या आयडेंटिटीज तुम्हाला सहजासहजी लिहिता येतात. सो त्याबद्दल फारसं टेन्शन घेण्याची आवश्यकता नाही आहे. वी डोंट हॅव टू टेक टेन्शन. सो वी इझिली रिमेंबर दी सी हाऊ मेनी आयडेंटिटीज 3 3 अँड 3 9 आयडेंटिटीज आर देअर, बट वी हॅव टू रिमेंबर दीज 3 ओनली. And we will easily get the 6 identities remaining by transferring one term and putting one term as it is. So this is all about the trigonometric identities. So we have two more identities. I will write that identities here. See, the first identity is tan a is equal to sin a upon cos a. Tan a is equal to sin a upon cos a. And we have one more identity, that is cot a is equal to cos a upon sin a. Tan a is equal to sin a upon cos a, and cot a is equal to cos a upon sin a. We have these two identities. If you have to prove these identities, we can prove it. See, we have sin a, we have cos a. Take the division of these two. We can easily prove these identities. Now here we have proof for all these identities here. We know the sin a, we know cosec a, and if we take the product, we will get sin a into cosec a is equal to 1. We prove all these three identities. Similarly, you can prove these two identities also. You can prove both these identities. See, we will write RHS only. we will write RHS only, that is sin A upon cos A. So RHS is equal to sin A upon cos A. Now put the value of sin A. What is the value of sin A? Value of sin A is BC upon AC. So here we write BC upon AC divided by value of cos A, it is AB upon AC. This is AB upon AC. Now here we can cancel AC, AC, or simply we can write this ratio as it is, that is BC upon AC as it is. In place of division we have to write multiplication, and now reciprocal of this AB upon AC, it is AC upon AB. Now here AC, AC gets cancelled and we have BC upon AB. And now you have to tell me what is BC upon AB. See, where is BC upon AB? See, this is BC upon AB, and what is BC upon AB? It is tan A. So we can remove this and we will write tan A here, tan A. So we prove sin A upon cos A is equal to tan A. Similarly, you can prove cot A is equal to cos A upon sin A. We know the value of cos A, we know the value of sin A. Put these values here and you will get cot A there. Take any one side, either left side or right side. If you take right side, you will get left side, and if you get left side, then you will obtain right side there. So you can easily prove these identities. No need to write proof there. Proofs are not asked in the exam, but we can prove it easily. We have all the proofs of these three identities. We have all the values here. Just we have to take multiplication of sin A and cos A, and that is equal to 1. We have to take the multiplication of cos and sec, and that is equal to 1. And we have to take the multiplication of tan and cot, and that is equal to 1 again. And from these three identities, we get 6 identities. But we have to remember these two identities carefully. That is, tan is the division of sin and cos, and cot is the division of cos and sin. As we know that tan and cot are reciprocals of each other. See, here we have sin A upon cos A, here we have reciprocal, that is cos A upon sin A. So we can easily remember these two identities. All these identities are very important. जेव्हा आपल्याला एक्झाम्पल सोडवायचे असतील, एल एच एस आणि आर एच एस इक्वल आहेत हे प्रूफ करून दाखवायचं असेल, तेव्हा आपल्याला ह्या आयडेंटिटीज अत्यंत महत्त्वाच्या आहेत. सो वी हॅव टू रिमेंबर ऑल दीज आयडेंटिटीज केअरफुली. मला जेवढं शक्य आहे तितक्या सोप्यात सोप्या पद्धतीनं तुम्हाला फक्त ह्या 3 आयडेंटिटीज लक्षात ठेवायच्या आहेत, आणि या 3 आयडेंटिटीजपासून ह्या 6 आयडेंटिटीज तुम्हाला प्रिपेअर करता येतात, त्या पाठ करण्याची आवश्यकता नाही आहे. आणि ह्या 2 आयडेंटिटीज सोबतच महत्त्वाच्या आहेत. प्रत्येक आयडेंटिटी आपण त्याचं प्रूफ देऊ शकतो, त्याची आवश्यकता नाही आहे. परंतु प्रूफ माहिती असेल तर आपल्याला ते बायहर्ट करण्याची, पाठ करण्याची आवश्यकता पडत नाही, ते लक्षात ठेवता आलं पाहिजे. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द ट्रिगोनॉमेट्रिक रेशियोज. वी हॅव मोर अँड मोर रिलेशन्स अमंग द ट्रिगोनॉमेट्रिक रेशियोज. खूप सारे रिलेशन्स आहेत. काल आपण 6 आयडेंटिटीज अभ्यासलेल्या होत्या. टी साईन थिटा इज इक्वल टू कॉस 90 मायनस थिटा, कॉस थिटा इज इक्वल टू साईन 90 मायनस थिटा, टॅन थिटा इज इक्वल टू कॉट 90 मायनस थिटा, कॉट थिटा इज इक्वल टू साईन टॅन 90 मायनस थिटा, सेक थिटा इज इक्वल टू कोसेक 90 मायनस थिटा, अँड कोसेक थिटा इज इक्वल टू सेक 90 मायनस थिटा. अँड टुडे वी स्टडीड दीज 9 अँड दीज 2, टोटल 11 आयडेंटिटीज. अँड यस्टरडे 6, 11 and 6, we have 17 identities in all, and we have more identities again. We have to study more identities again, and then we have to take the example.